So we are about 2.5 months away from the Iowa caucus, and there are still Democrats jumping in the 2020 race. I mean, what is going on? We had Michael Bloomberg enter the race last week, and now another Democrat, specifically a corporate Democrat, Deval Patrick, former governor of Massachusetts, will be entering the race. So as Jonathan Martin explains, former Governor Deval Patrick of Massachusetts told senior Democrats Wednesday that he will enter the presidential race, according to two party officials, reversing his decision last year to forego a run and adding yet more volatility to an unusually fluid Democratic primary. Mr. Patrick will enter the race Thursday morning and head to New Hampshire's State House to file paperwork to be a candidate on the primary ballot there. According to a Democrat familiar with his plans, Mr. Patrick was calling a list of party leaders Wednesday to inform them of his decision and is planning to begin his campaigning with a video and new website. Joining the campaign less than 3 months before the first votes are cast in Iowa, at a moment when candidates are usually dropping out and not jumping in, Mr. Patrick will face long odds. Yet his decision to run reflects the fractured nature of the Democratic race at a moment when Michael R. Bloomberg, the former mayor of New York City, has also taken steps to enter the primary. I find it really hilarious the way that he's going about this because he is incredibly transparent. What he's doing is he's contacting Democratic Party leaders because he wants to communicate to them that in the likely event Joe Biden fails, because he's already face-planted, he wants to be their backup plan. He wants to be the establishment's insurance policy against Bernie Sanders. Because Joe Biden, let's face it, even though he's polling very well nationally, he's still in the lead. In early primary states, he has lost his lead, and it doesn't seem like he's going to retake the lead. So what the establishment is looking for is anyone who can save them from a Bernie Sanders. So what he's doing is he's telling them that he wants to be their new golden boy. He doesn't want that to be Pete Buttigieg. He wants to be the one who is the establishment's new favorite. Now, I'm going to share a tweet that pretty much sums up everything you need to know about Deval Patrick. Not only is he a foreclosure mogul, but on top of that, as Alex Koch points out, he worked for Texaco, Coca-Cola, subprime mortgage lender ACC Capital Holdings, and currently he works at Bain Capital.
No! God, please, no! No!
So he has that in common with Mitt Romney, at least. So he's not going to win. He doesn't have a chance. And, you know, the establishment is incredibly upset that Joe Biden lost. Well, he's not out of it yet. He didn't lose yet, right? But it seems likely that Joe Biden isn't going to work out too well for them. You know, he's not doing as well as he was initially. He lost that lead. And they want a fallback option. And none of the other options are even, you know, anywhere near Joe Biden. The next closest bet is Pete Buttigieg, right? But I think that they probably realize that Pete Buttigieg is going to fail hard in a general election in the event he goes up against Donald Trump. He's too elitist. He is absolutely establishment for sure. I don't really think he has a political identity. He just kind of sees whatever way the wind is blowing. And that's what he did in this primary. And then he chose a lane and decided to be centrist as opposed to being progressive like he was at the beginning. But he's going to lose. And they want someone who's going to win, and they want someone who's safe. Joe Biden was their safe choice, but he's out, so they're looking for anyone. As Alex Koch pointed out, first it was Tom Steyer. Well, he's not gaining any traction. Then it was Michael Bloomberg. Seems like, you know, Democrats don't really like him, and now it's going to be Deval Patrick, and the same thing will be true. So what the establishment is going to have to realize is that they're not going to get their number one choice this time, most likely. They are not going to get their number one choice. And it's really nice to see the establishment scramble. But you know what? It's just too late. Like, this is wishful thinking to jump in this late as some sort of savior. I mean, it just shows how arrogant people like Michael Bloomberg and Deval Patrick are. So, he's not going to win. I doubt he'd even reach 3% in the polls. He's going to really have to have the media put in overtime to prop him up. But this is another candidate who wants to be the establishment's savior, who will inevitably faceplant. And I'll be happy to watch that and make fun of him when he ultimately does.
The Humanist Report is fake news. Mike only cares about Crazy Bernie and his wacky socialist ideas. Sad, very sad. I'm unsubscribing.